straight line like this. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
What effect will putting a negative 1 in front of x have on the graph? That means I am replacing my x with negative x. It will reflect on the reflect is the correct word, but about what? Reflect the right y is equal to no, exactly. Okay, now confusion.
Shes
is saying it will reflect, but he is not sure whether it will reflect about actually, common sense will say that let's plot this and see where it is getting reflected, right? So if I plot this, all of you can guess that the graph would actually look like this. Yes or no? So it has reflected about y-axis. So this is reflected about y-axis. That means this part has become this part, and this part has become this part. Yes or no? Okay. Now, quick rule over here. The rule is, if you replace your x with minus x in any function, even though I took a straight line just to explain you, in any function, if you replace your x with minus x, the graph of the function will get reflected about which axis? About the y-axis. Then the graph will be reflected about the y-axis. Now the funny thing is, I did not show you this on y equal to x square because you would not appreciate it. Because the moment you replace x with minus x, nothing happens to the graph. Because the graph was originally the mirror image about y-axis, correct? So even if I reflect it about y-axis, will you see any change in the graph? Nothing. That's why I did not show you on a parabola. I showed you on a straight line. But let me tell you, this rule is universally applicable. Is that fine? Now, instead of changing the sign of x over here, if I would have changed the sign of y, what will happen? What will happen now? Common sense says that changing the sign of x reflects the graph about y-axis. So changing the sign of y should reflect it about x-axis. Now this is common sense, but logically also you can derive this by saying that if you are changing the sign of x, that means what you are doing for the same y, now my x is negative of itself, isn't it? Correct? Yes or no? So let's say initially I got y is equal to 5 from x equal to 2. Now in this case, my y equal to 5 would come from x equal to minus 2. Correct? So whatever was the point here, let's say this was your y equal to 5, it came from 2, then the same 5 equal to 5 will now come from minus 2. Let's say 4 here, came from 1, correct? Then 4 here will come from minus 1. So it's obvious that every point is getting reflected about y-axis, and hence the graph itself gets reflected about y-axis. Right? Changing the sign of y, what happens? Let's say initially your y value was, let's say, give me any y value here. Any value you want? 6. Okay. So y is equal to 6 means, y equal to 6 means x should be how much? X should be 3. Yes or no? Now for the same 3 value over here, y will now become negative 6. Understood the point? In this graph, when x was 3, y was 6. Correct? In this value, if you put x as 3, y will now become negative 6. Y will become negative 6. I'm not saying negative y. So what is happening? For the same point, 3, 6. Now I'm going to 3, minus 6. That means y is becoming negative. When is y becoming negative? Is when you take its mirror image about x-axis. So rule number two in the same thing is, when you change your sign of, I'm just erasing this part. When you change your y with minus y, you actually reflect the graph about x-axis. So it's very simple rule. Change of sign of x, reflection about y-axis. Change of sign of y, reflection about x-axis. Is the rule clear? Just one quick problem I'll give you and then we'll have a break. Okay? 3 minus y is equal to x plus 2 the whole square. Think properly, think carefully, take your time and then plot this graph. Mark its vertex and where it cuts the x-axis, the y-axis. Let's go step by step. Okay. Can we start? Which is the skeleton graph? Y is equal to x squared. I will start with the skeleton graph. Maybe pink color. Okay. Y is equal to x squared. Correct? Now what do you want to do next? I have to achieve this transformation. What do you want to do next? Do you want to replace your x with x plus 2 or do you want to change your y with minus 5? What do you want to do? Your call. Everybody is saying they want to do x. So this is your graph of x square. Now you want to change your x with x plus 2. What will happen to this graph?
Left side.
2 units to the
left.
Left. Not right.
Left.
Left. So it will become like this now. Correct me if I'm wrong. What will be the position of the vertex now? Minus 2 comma 0. So the graph has moved to the left. Next, what do you want to do? Next, what do you want to do? Now, there are various approaches over here. Do you want to change y with y plus 3 right now?
Y plus
3. Or do you want to change your y with negative y?
Y plus 3 plus y.
Now, this is the confusion that people had last year. How do you decide the order of the transformation?
What?
If you get to the same result, any order will work fine. But let me tell you, in some cases, the order of transformation will matter. Correct. I'll show you in which cases. Krishna will tell me. Krishna, do you want to change y with what? I want to reach this. This is my target. What should I do with the y? Okay, Krishna says I want to do y plus 3. Let's see whether whatever he is planning to do will lead the result. Krishna says, let's do y plus 3. What will happen to the same graph? This will come down by 3 units. Agreed? Agreed. So can I say it will now become like this? Again, it may seem to pass through origin, but it is not. So this point will be 2 comma minus 3. Correct? Next, what do you want to do, Krishna? You wanted a minus y to come over here. Means you're replacing your y with minus y. If you replace your y with minus y, again let me choose some other color. It will become minus y plus 3 is equal to x plus 2 square. Minus y means what? Reflecting the graph about x-axis. Remember the rule. Changing the sign of x, reflecting the graph about y-axis. Changing the sign of y, reflecting the graph about x-axis. So if I reflect this graph about the x-axis, correct me whether this is what you see? Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay. Now to be more accurate, it will actually look like this. this vertex position will now be at minus 2, comma 3. Understood? Can you verify this on GeoGebra? Let's verify this on GeoGebra. So the graph was
b minus y is equal to x.
B minus y
is equal to x.
Is equal to
the whole
square. It's no talking please. X
plus 2 the whole square.
Plus 2
the whole square.
The whole square. Do you see this?
Why?
Ignore this one. Do you see this? Does it match with whatever we did here? Yes or no? Now, can I draw the same thing in an alternative approach? I'll just show you another approach, then I'll give you a break. So I have to reach the graph of 3 minus y is equal to x plus 2 the whole square. See what I do first. First of all, I'll start with this graph. This is fine. It will look like this. Correct? Then I will change the x with x plus 2. What will happen here?
2 units to the left.
2 units to the left. Then I will change here y with minus y itself. So unlike Krishna's approach where he first changed his y with y plus 3, I will not take that approach. I will first take y as minus y. So what am I doing? I am reflecting the graph about x axis. So let me choose a different color.
Opposite direction.
Yes. Correct? Now, who will tell me how would I achieve 3 minus y from minus y? Can I say if I do this? That means if I change the y over here with y minus 3, I will get to this. Yes or no?
Yeah.
So if you are changing y with y minus 3, you are pushing the graph 3 units up. So this graph will go 3 units up. And if it goes 3 units up, it will look like this. And this is my final result. I ended up drawing the same graph, but this time the approach was delta different, slightly different. So it doesn't matter in this case whether you do y plus 3 and then change y to minus y, or you do y with minus y first and then change y with y minus 3. Ultimately, you have to reach this expression somehow. Understood? So we'll take a break for 5-10 minutes. Anybody who hasn't got this handout? Anybody if I have missed out?